Good afternoon, boys. I will be teaching you topographical maps today. This is for all the three sections of class 10. And if you have your total geography book in front of you, the first three chapters are the explanation of this topic. It is a single topic. The first three chapters, I repeat, are our explanation of this topic. And the fourth chapter is question answers. Maps have been provided in the textbook only, and question answers you have to solve. Clear? Now, please pay attention. This is a very, very new topic to you. In the beginning, you will find it difficult. But if you keep practicing it, following the instructions which I am giving you, you will begin to find it easy. You will not find it difficult. But you have to listen, pay attention and practice. Something like maths it is. If you stop doing it, you forget it. Now, the word topographical is a combination of topo and graphical. Topos means the face of the earth or surface of the earth. And graphical means presentation in detail, description in detail. So when we combine the two words, it means a map which is like a picture of the earth's surface, meaning everything on the earth's surface it depicts. Clear? I repeat, topos is the earth's surface and graphical is like a picture presentation. Very, very accurate presentation it will be, showing everything that is there on the earth's surface. Now, topographical maps are also called contour maps. Clear? The reason is we use contour lines. They are called contour maps because of contour lines which are used on these maps. Now everybody has seen the atlas maps. You know what a map of North America looks like. You know what a map of India looks like, or any other country. These topo maps look like this. Okay? They look like this. And in your total geography book, you have these maps at the back, right at the end of the book. Few samples you have at the end of the book. And those are the ones from which we will be practicing question answers. Clear? In the beginning, when you look at these maps, it does not make any sense because everything is new to you. Slowly, as you learn about how to read, we call it reading the map, everything will become clear to you. So on these maps you will notice mountains are not shown like this or with a thick line, which we used to do earlier. Mountains or valleys or any other landform, whether it is a mountain, a plateau or a plain, it is shown with the help of contour lines. Now contour lines are irregular lines like this. They may be like this, or in an area, if I make a box, in an area they may be running like this. These are contour lines. Clear? These contour lines are drawn in patterns, a particular design. That design tells you what landform this is. Clear? So a circular pattern of contour lines, this stands for a hill or a mountain. Clear? How it stands for a hill or mountain, I will explain later. Just now, I'm just telling you the use of these contour lines. Clear? Every landform, I repeat, mountains, plains, plateaus, valleys are shown by contour lines. That is why these maps are also called contour maps. Now, one more name is there. We also call them survey maps. Survey maps. Clear? The meaning of the word survey means to go to a place, travel to a particular area and see everything in detail. And when we are making a map, how do we see it? We measure the distances of the places. Accurate measurement is taken. It is reduced according to a scale which is chosen. Clear? And on the paper, then the map is drawn. So, topographical or contour maps have been drawn by cartographers. Cartographers are people who draw maps. only after the work of surveying has been done. That is why they are very, very accurate. So all the three names you should be familiar with: topographical, contour and survey sheets. Sheets also we call it, maps also we call it. Now, in the board exam, you will, every student gets a separate survey sheet. Same map it is, clear? It is printed out in large numbers and given to the students so that each one has his own map to solve questions on. Now, it is a very, very important topic. Earlier I have said it, again I am repeating it. This is the only question which carries 20 marks. Plus, it is a compulsory question. The first question in your question paper is on contour maps and it carries 20 marks. Now, what type of marks it carries? This question will be question number 1 and it has A to approximately J parts. 10 subdivisions will be there, clear? And these subdivisions, either it is 1 marks or 2 marks or little bit more than that, but not more than 2 or 3. Maximum it will go up to 3 marks, because if question number A has part 1, part 2, part 3, each will carry 3 marks, like that. Clear? So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, many subdivisions are there and total is 20 marks. That is why you need to understand it very nicely. Now, certain things about the topo maps you should know. First of all, they are large scale maps. Large scale maps. Now, in this case, you should know the meaning of the word scale. Scale is something which shows the relationship between map distance and ground distance. Clear? Any two places on the ground, we measure the distance. Now suppose the distance is 5 kilometers. We can't show 5 kilometers on paper. So we have to reduce it to according to a certain scale. Clear? And that scale in case of topographical maps is a large scale. Meaning, in case of the topographical maps in your syllabus, you have a scale of 2 centimeter equals 1 kilometer. This is your scale. Meaning, 1 kilometer on ground between two points is brought down to 2 centimeters on paper. Clear? So, that is how then we will be able to show the entire area on paper. So, please remember, maps are of two varieties: small scale maps, large scale maps. Atlas maps are small scale maps. In the atlas map, if you are looking for Ranchi, clear, the capital city of Jharkhand, it is just like a small dot, no bigger than a small dot, and we can't make out anything else about Ranchi other than that it is a capital city. But in a survey map, Ranchi will be shown in great detail. Every area of Ranchi will be shown with man-made, with natural plus cultural features. So this is your second point. I'm leaving this, you can keep this in brackets. These are large scale maps. Secondly, they show three things. What are the three things? Man-made, natural and cultural features. Cultural features all together instead of repeating the word features. Every type of thing, or not only mountains and rivers and plains are shown on these maps. On these maps, if there is a hut also, you know what a hut is. Poor people live in huts. Not a proper construction, not a proper building. Even that hut is shown on the map. Suppose there is a very old tree, which is a prominent landmark, even that will be shown on these maps. Clear? Cultural features means related to temples and churches and mosques. Whether there's a graveyard anywhere, even that will be shown. So accurate and detailed they are. Clear? So they are large scale maps. They show all these three features. Come to the next point about these. The color and symbols. Colors are right. Colors and symbols which are very specific are used on these maps. I repeat again, colors that are used on these maps are different from the colors which are used on the atlas map, and you have to learn the color scheme. Symbols also are given on the map sheet. Still, it is preferable to learn it and remember it. They are very, very specific. There can be no confusion with any other type of map. So you have to learn it. Okay? Then the next thing, write down. This is for your general knowledge. These maps have been, I'm rubbing out these points. The fourth feature or important thing, point about these maps is they have been prepared by the Survey of India organization. Means it's a government organization. Officially they are prepared. It's not by a private agency. Clear? The Survey of India prepares these maps, and these maps have a lot of importance for defense, for tourism, for administration, lot of things. Few examples only I'm giving you. Clear? So you can see these maps are of great importance, not only to you as students of class 10, because it is a part of your syllabus. In UPSC geography syllabus, this is included. Clear? Because people should know or have a very good idea about the geography of their different parts of their country. And the only possible method is through topographical maps. So these points just are telling you the basics about topographical maps. The introductory part of the chapter you do not get as question answers. But please read it so that you get an idea what these maps are about, and why we need to study it, why they have included it in your syllabus. Now, the next thing I tell you is, the information on a topo sheet, short form we use, on a topo sheet. What all things are there on the single sheet which is provided to you? The first thing you should know about a topo map is its index number. Index number, also known as sheet number. Sheet number, short form I'm writing. Now, the number in your sheets, the sheets will be provided. If you are asked as a question, normally they don't ask it, but you should be able to identify it for revision work also, for practice work also. It is written as 45 capital D slash 7. This is in your syllabus. 45 D slash 10. These are the two maps in your syllabus. Okay. Now, it's not just two maps only. From these two maps, many, many extracts can be taken out. Now, in your literature, in your Merchant of Venice, you do reference to context. From one scene, so many, many extracts can be taken out. From one act and one scene, lot of extracts can be taken out. Any two dialogues can be taken. Same thing happens with this. You can get 45D7, the previous batch must have got it. You will also get 45D7 possibly, clear? But it will not be the same. There will be similarities, but it will not be the same. So please keep that in mind. I repeat, these two maps are in your syllabus. No other number is there. So get used to how we write it. I will explain how we get this number later on. The next information on the sheet that you find is the scale. Now, for scale, please write down the definition. It is a ratio between map distance and ground distance. and ground distance between the same corresponding points. Between the same corresponding points. Clear? Most important, this term, map distance, ground distance, you should know. And the word ratio. You can write relationship also, not a problem, but this, learn it as it is. Whenever you are asked the definition of scale of any kind, you are writing this definition. This scale is shown on the map sheet itself at the bottom part, in the lower part of the sheet. Clear? Over here you will see three types of scale have been shown. Now, write down the names of these three types. The first type is written as 1:50,000. Can you see it clearly on the map sheet? If you keep it in front of you, this is how it is written.